very happy to mix it. Oh, but he takes the left hand. Gianni, anyway, he wasn't far off.
Great left by Sammy.
It's over. With 100 seconds left in the second round. And I must say, that was an absolute exhibition.
Janet, JT Todd!
Shots right up in the middle, just like that. Beautiful jab to a body shot.
There's a very interesting technique that...
Oh, hey,
he took
it
first! Smack right! From Janet Todd! Vandaryeva! Lay down in the circle! Rafael Nari puts the cannons on!
Tonight, Myanmar flags are flying, so too Filipino flags for Brandon Vera. Now from Vera off the back leg. Doubles up and into Vera. Power salvos early from the legs of the truth. Body shot, belly button through the back from Olan's side. Outside leg kick from Olan. Checks the low kick to Brandon. Olan fights. Wants to throw the steel pipe. Throws the steel pipe! Looks for the gap to hook. Try for the Muay clinch there. Did Brandon Vera. Vera switches.
He stands his turn to time there. Incoming shots. Online song.
Vera in southpaw stance now. On left hand's now the power hand. Omar edging forward. Roundhouse kick scooped away by Vera. Scooped away by Ola.
Great body shots.
Looping left hand there from Ola. Cracking out some leg kick from Ola's side. Tremendous power from both these men. Spinning hook kick from Ola.
Brandon Bear's been working on those leg techniques. He knows that Ola's son wants to come in with the kicks. Brandon Bear's looking to counter.
Ola fights. Gets out of the way of the long-reaching left hand. It's orthodox starts now for Vera. He circles on captain block one. Back to center circle. Both men trade hooks.
You can hear the entire left side of the stadium is absolutely quiet while the right side is just pulsing the energy.
High kick there from Ola. Brandon throws the jab.
Encounter from Vera. And Ransan catches him with the jab coming in.
Ola dances forward, left kick to right hand. Looks for a fadeaway hook up and right there to Brandon Vera.
This is already Brandon Vera's longest match of the championship. elbows inside that clinch. Nice hand combination thrown by Aung Lan Sung.
Brandon said he wants it on Lana Thornburg. He welcomed it in. He gave him the dime to make the phone call on the inside.
We talked a lot about the counter striking coming from Brandon Vera, but Aung Lan Sung is not paying any attention to it. He has no fear marching forward, throwing big shots.
This crowd going bananas here in Tokyo. They are charging Aung Lan's name. Aung Lan with the jab. 135 remains, first round of five. We're not going to go to five, surely not. Not in this one. Fake there, and a crossing elbow, Muay Thai from Brandon Vera. 59% of fans believe Ogla wins tonight. 41% say Brandon Vera.
Again, with a big body kick thrown by Brandon Vera. He's also setting up. You can see the way kind of Aung Lan Sung protects the body. I'd like to see Brandon Vera fake the body kick over the head punch.
The big question tonight was what would happen if Aung Lan tests the jaw of Vera. No one in one championship is yet to cleanly hit the jaw of Brandon Vera. But Aung Lan's got the steel pipe. Can he land it? Goes for the headmaker. The overhand right.
Barely misses that shot. Brandon Vera was just able to get his hand up in time. Ooh, Brandon Vera steps inside with the uppercut elbow.
45 seconds to go in the first round.
I like the leg kicks.
A magnificent opener.
I like the leg kicks coming from Aung Lan Sung. He's got to do more of that. Slow down that movement. Slow down that constant stance switch is coming from Brandon Vera.
Brandon back to southpaw stance. Gets out of the way of the round kick. Back to center circle. This crowd rabid in Tokyo. They are loving every moment of it. The main events of one century.
There's some of those body kicks are getting through, Michael. You can hear that thud. It's like a baseball bat cracking.
Vera circles off to his right. Drifting away from the power side of Aung Lan, away from the steel pipe. Aung Lan fakes it. There's the drift away hook, and there's a lead hook from Brandon. Aung Lan smiles at it. And we go to the towels at the end of one. Folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms. At One Championship, on Facebook, on Twitter, and on Instagram.
Look at this. Brandon Vera rushes forward, barely misses with a knee, but a beautifully timed elbow inside the clinch landed by Brandon Vera. Oh, and the knee just barely grazes the jaw of Aung Lan Sung. I like how Aung Lan Sung's moving forward, though. I like how he changes stances. He comes in with that big right hand. He's in southpaw stance. I'd like to see him keep going with it. Man, you can hear the whole hush kind of fall over this crowd on that one side. You can hear Martin Nguyen in the corner.
Mitch, how about this? Aung Lan standing between rounds. Brandon Vera took a seat. Can you read anything into that?
Brandon Vera's a veteran. He knows how to recover. But this is the first time he's been into the sixth minute of a match. This is the whole uncharted territory.
Brandon Vera hasn't been into the second round of a match since 2013. More than 6 years ago.
Brandon Vera says that's not a problem. He consistently trains hard in the fourth and fifth rounds. He is happy to be in deep water. He wants to get taken into the deep end and see what kind of metal he's really got.
It's been all standing so far. We haven't gone to the ground. On the ground, Vera has one sub. Aung Lan has 12 submissions. 5 guillotines, 5 arm bars included.
Yeah, Michael, I don't know if this is going to go to the ground. I think these guys want to put on a show and they are looking for a knockdown.
Just a slip there for Aung Lan. Overhand right, he kind of couldn't get sloppy because I believe Vera beats him for speed and precision. Outside leg kick to that common peroneal nerve just above the lead knee from Aung Lan.
Every time Brandon's an orthodox, Aung Lan Sung is touching that lead leg. You can see a beautiful check there.
You see the Baybayin Filipino writing on the back of Brandon Vera.
Damage, Michael.
Oh, Muay Thai flinch in me! And Aung Lan caught the uppercut! He up caught the uppercut! But it doesn't drop Vera! It dropped Hasegawa! It knocked Hasegawa out! But not Vera!
Both these guys got iron chins. They are eating each other's best shots. And they're still standing. It's going to take a remarkable effort to put one of these two monsters down.
Step through knee from Vera. After he threw a crossing elbow. Aung Lan comes forward, always plodding forward. He wants to drill the steel pipe to the jaw. Both men in southpaw stance.
Those low kicks are starting to touch Brandon. You can see how he's taking them. He's stepping gingerly on those legs.
The low kicks will slow down the boxing of Brandon Vera. Vera tries Got to watch that drift away lead hook of Brandon Vera. That's what he knocked out now, Rosa, really with. What's the gas tank like of Brandon Vera at light heavyweight in the second round? Round kick from Vera.
He's starting to move. Beautiful roundhouse kick to a straight left hand there, landed by Vera. Rolland Sunset's unfazed by the power. He's wearing these punches very well.
Although it's a stiff left hand from Brandon. And continues to get forward, swings the legs again.
In with a big leg kick. You can see Brandon starting to get a little bit wobbly. I don't know if he's hurt him though.
And leg kick. That lead leg in Vera has taken tremendous punishment. Body shot from Rolland. Gotta be careful that drift away hook. Then the left hook from Vera. That's the uppercut. Another left hook. Machado to win the left heavyweight crown.
Mr. Olivier Cost has pulled a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 23 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, and still one light heavyweight world champion,
amazing performance from Aung Sang. You cosmic kite, where did you come from? Myanmar's national hero, their national treasure, their only world champion of anything.
And a young man from France on the right of your picture who says it's just crazy to be here, loves the atmosphere, loves the event, and is primed to take his position amongst the elite here in the ONE Championship fold.
Rolland going up on a tough test here today. The former ONE Flyweight World Champion, former Super Flyweight Champion of Lupini. Zame is one of the best in the game.
One of the best is right, and you can see the composure from Zame, can't you? Into his stance, comfortable in his body. Rolland, very busy, jumping up and down, hands moving, legs moving, exchanging kicks at the moment. Rolland will be very happy to mix it. Oh, but he takes a left hand and smiles through it. Wasn't going to get any respite from the referee. Still smiling, but that certainly landed and certainly woke him up. And that's how Zame can just pick you off. Look at the way he moves. Great economy of effort. Strides towards you.
And everything just so calculated. No sudden movements by Zame.
Understands the geography of the circle just as he understands the geography of a squared ring supremely well. Knows how to cover that ground with the minimum of effort. Stop. He misjudged that, didn't he? Went for the spectacular kick, missed completely, landed on his backside. Once again, but this time there was more input from Zame, tripped him.
Zame had a long layoff in his last bout. He said that contributed to his performance. But now, down to strawweight, feels amazing, he said. Never feel better.
He runs so much. Yeah, cardio is not going to be an issue for him, is it? Controlling his weight, not going to be an issue. And at the moment, landing punches at will, not an issue either. Knee, brings that knee up to the head.
Short elbow there inside the clinch by Zame.
Stop! Separate!
And Rolland looking at the moment as if he just needs to settle down a little bit. Because all of that composure from the Thai athlete is coming through supremely well for now. Look at the way he just cuts, eats up the space between him and his opponent. And once again, Rolland sent to his backside. 40 seconds left in this opening round. Another big left hand from Sam A. Just picks them. Picks them off, doesn't he?
Sam A going hands and low kicks with this bout against a taller opponent. Wants to neutralize the movement and the height. Get in with his punches and land low kicks to slow him down.
How can he make this rangy height difference work in his advantage, the Frenchman? Is the top. Oh, a good right hand, and he drops Sam A to his knees. That'll give him tremendous confidence right at the end of the round, because we were seeing the Thai athlete really come to prominence over this first 3 minutes. Big confidence booster. To add to that super right hand punch that dropped Sam A, there was a nice elbow just as the bell rang there. Let's have another look at some of the actions.
Here's the straight left that stumbled Rolland. Kicks to the body, but this was the shot that hurt Sam A. Just the right hook off the kick of Sam A.
And he had the presence of Mike Gianni to follow it up with the knee as well. He's looking for that stoppage, and that's what he can produce. Sam A, as controlled and comfortable as he looks, cannot relax here.
Cannot. Darren Rolland is an experienced opponent. He's the champion as well, and he's hungry, looking for a big debut here in ONE Championship.
Doesn't get much bigger to make your debut than this event. ONE Century, we're in Tokyo, Japan. It's the 100th event in ONE Championship history, part one of a doubleheader.
Okay, ready, ready, up!
5 3-minute rounds, we've had one of them. Potentially 12 more minutes to come, and judges will score this round by round using the 10-point must system. The exchange of kicks early in this round, and the pace has increased as compared with the first 3 minutes. Sam A has really stepped things up.
And Sam A going back to the low kicks, chopping on the long legs of Rolland.
He got a bit of a surprise towards the end of that round, didn't he? And maybe that just told him that he needs to just move things up a level. It's a marathon, not a sprint. 5 rounds here, and Sam A knows that better than anybody.
Rolland not phased at all by Sam A. He's throwing back strikes of his own.
Just getting caught on the top of the head, stumbling back into the wall of the circle. What a prospect facing Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. You just cannot hide. We'll catch up with you.
Oh, then look for a spinning elbow.
Twice. Gianni, and he wasn't far off, but Sam
A. Great left! Great left by Sam A.
Sent that left in towards the chin. It doesn't look to me as if Rolland's getting up. He's on his back, arms to the side. We're at the count of nine, and it's over. With 100 seconds left in the second round, and I must say, that was an absolute exhibition. And when you consider that you're doing that in what? Your 420th odd contest, he could still pull it out the bag, can't he? What an exhibition of cool martial arts. Leaning out of range, sending that left hand in. Gianni, beautiful to watch.
Beautiful, leans back, slips the jab of Rolland, and then short left toss right down the middle. Drops Rolland.
That was just fabulous. To watch that in slow motion as well, the way he evaded that attack and then drew on the counter-attack with punishing, beautifully timed blows, and out of your picture, wonderful respect. The Frenchman, Darren Rolland, on his knees, offering his respect to our winner. And we'll get the official pronouncement from Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Ilias Dolapsis, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 20 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Sam A. Gaiyanghadao.
Improves his record to 367, 47 and 9. Sam A. Gaiyanghadao on his birthday, and what a way to celebrate. Superb performance, beautiful to watch. Can't wait to see him again. This is One Century. We're live in Tokyo, Japan, and there is so much more to come.